already sewing, or do you want to learn? Welcome to Power Sewing.
Hi, I'm Sandra Betzina. Today what I want to show you is how to make pillows, but this is a really cool pillow. I call it a pillow stack. You see, it looks like this from the top, and it kind of swivels around, and it has three layers. And I originally saw this pillow, this idea in Japan, but it was real small, and I thought, oh, that could be fabulous. And you could just do such great fabrics. This came from an obi that I had that was damaged. There was only one part that was good, so I used that part. So, you know, if you can look around for some little cool fabrics that kind of go together. And then there are just so many fabrics that work well. For example, they've got some great cottons out there. This is another cotton. And if you're planning to launder these, I'd probably throw it in the washing machine and the dryer first. And this is, you know, another cotton. Amy Butler has some wonderful, you know, modern kind of prints that you find in quilting stores. And they're really nice. And here's a piece of velveteen. So any of these will work. But the one I'm going to be working on is I'm going to make one out of an old curtain. And I have a daughter that loves this kind of thing. And you know, this is that old bark cloth, and a lot of you probably still like it too. And if you have any old curtains, the thing is, you can make a lot of pillows from this curtain. I'll give you an example. I'll put this down. See how wide this is. Now they've seamed it together, but I didn't worry about that. You know, if the seam is on the back, it doesn't bother me one bit. Because what we're going to cut, are we're going to cut 14-inch squares. I end up, this pillow size is the one I usually make, ends up being 13 inches when it's finished. And the reason I like that size is when I make brocade, do you see I can get two side by side? But you see here, I cut the pillow 14. I cut it 1 inch bigger in each direction, so I have a half inch seam all the way around. But you see, I can cut one here, I can go all the way across. I mean, I was able to get four of these right from one. And I did cut off the hems. I don't want the hems on there. And I didn't mind. In this case, there was a seam. That didn't bother me because I'll use it on the underside. All right. So now let's look at what else. Okay, now the thing is, we're going to need something to stuff this with. Now, we don't want to use, this is what's called a pillow form. And we're not going to use a pillow form because, do you see, three of these, it would just be too big. Instead, I like to use batting. Now, there are different ways. I love 2-inch batting, but sometimes they don't have that. Now, this is 1-inch, and do you see, I can use the two together. That would be just about right. Or I could take, you know, if I only had a half inch, do a couple of layers. But what I want to do is I don't want to cut the batting the same size as the pillow. I want to cut it an inch smaller all the way around because I want to be able to slide it in there really easily. So I've got these two now. I've got two cut out. And so what I have, so really we're going to make three little pillows. And I only, my middle one, the only one I had that would kind of work with this, is this. So my little one will be out of this fabric. So I have two of the fabric that came from the curtains. So now they're 14 inches square, and make sure it's square. I mean, get in the habit of using a ruler and squaring it up, because that's when things look really wonky and end up looking really homemade. I mean, when I was younger, boy, I was the original fast and dirty sewer. And I still have that side to me. But in cases like this, you want it to be nice and square. So now what we're going to do is we're going to go over to the machine and we're going to sew this together. Now, before we start sewing, let's decide where a half inch seam would be. So I put this little measuring tape here and put my needle down at a half inch. And then I'm going to put some little tape, this is that painter's tape there, so that I have, it's like a little fence. So when I start sewing the seams, they will all be uniform, because that's the hardest thing, especially if you're a new sewer, to get seams that are uniform. Now I'm not going to start right on the end. I'm going to start about 3 inches from the corner, and I've got a regular stitch length, and this is not needle particular. Now when I come to the corner, what I want to do is I want to hand walk it. That means let the wheel do two walks, and my stitches are not real big because, do you see, I want it to, I've got a 2.0 stitch length, so that this, if it were laundered, it would still hold up. You know, pillows get a lot of workout. So we come down here to the next corner, leave our needle in, and you see, lift up the presser foot, and you see how I walk two stitches. And the reason I do that is fabric is not like paper, and it needs room to turn. So see how I'm just guiding it along here with my hands? You know, sewing can be such fun if you're just not all nervous about it, you know, and I find I don't like to take things out either. And so I find little things like having the tape will make it so that it's the same, all of these pillows are the same size. So now I'm getting ready to come around here to the last corner. And you see, you always put it on the diagonal. And the only reason you hand walk it is I can't make the foot pedal only go two stitches. All right, so now what we have is, always get in the habit of not cutting your thread too close, because then it always comes unthreaded when it takes up the stitch. Okay, so we've sewn all the way around. Now let's go over, we've left an opening here that's, I don't know, it's probably about maybe 9 inches. Not so tiny, because you want to be able to get the stuffing in. So let's now go to the iron so that we can do our next step. Now the next thing we do, I want to take all the seams and press them back on itself. Now what that means is, I can't really open up the seams very easily because I can't get in there. And so what I do is I take the fabric and I lift it back. I lift one layer back, and that allows me to get in there and press one. Now this fabric was certainly not needle particular. Almost any needle would sew on this fabric, you know, except I'd say at least a 12 or a 14. Because if a needle is too small, like a size 10, what will happen is the thread will break because it's too small to, you know, go through the fabric repeatedly. Now this is my open side. I am still going to press that open because what I want to do is I'm going to have to close that up later, and my press marks will show me where to do it. And I'll even take, and on the open side, I'll even take and press back on, so that on my open side, let me hold this open so you can see, I've got it pressed back a little bit. Everywhere else, I have it pressed open all the way around. Now, my next thing I do is I have to trim the bulk out of these seam allowances. So the first thing I always do is take and I go all the way around the pillow and I cut the corners off diagonally. Now, not too close, maybe an eighth of an inch away, but I still want to cut those off. Now, my next thing is, now not in the opening area, leave the seam allowances full size in the opening area, but for the rest, I want to cut all the way around and give myself about, say, quarter inch seams. Nice little sharp scissors like this. Small ones are really good. They're 6 inch ones, 5 or 6 inches, and they're just so much easier to handle, I think, than long shears for this job. But, you know, use what you have. And if you don't have a lot of nice equipment, this is things that you can ask for Christmas and your birthday. And because, you know, I notice a lot of people, even good sewers, have some really funky scissors.
So what do you think?
About what?
Power sewing.